Hey, so today I just want to come and encourage you that to let you know that even in the midst of what it looks maybe a drought season, God can still provide. There's still provision. And a lot of times that we find ourselves in situations and we're in a place where it seems like it's barren, it's dry, it's not fruitful. And that could be whether it could be in your body, it could be in your relationships. Maybe your friends are getting married. It can be in your finances, and you can look at other people and see God prosper in them, and it's like you're at a place where it's like a drought. Nothing is happening. In those moments, we have to make sure we be intentional about trusting God. My reference scripture, I'm going to 1 Kings 17, and you all may know the story about the widow and Elijah was sent there because there was somebody going to sustain him. And here's this lady, and it's been a drought, we know, and she's saying how we would say. The man of God came to the house and she was like saying, "Hey, I just have enough of me and my son. We're gonna die. I don't have nothing else." And you know, somebody coming to us, "Hey, give me something. Give me before you do this. Give me mine first." You know, like God is telling me, tell you this. You're like, "Hold on, I ain't got enough. We ain't got nothing to eat. So what we gonna eat if I give it to you?" You know how that is. Like, and she had to be obedient to to God. So I'm gonna read the verse. It says, 1 Kings 17, and let me go to 10. So he arose, this Elijah, and went to Zarephath. And when he came to the gate of the city, behold, the widow woman was there gathering of sticks. And he called to her and said, "Fetch me, I pray thee, a little water in a vessel that I may drink." And as she was going to fetch it, he called her, "Bring me thee a morsel of bread in thy hand." Verse 12. And she said, "As the Lord," and she said, "As the Lord thy God liveth, I have not a cake but bread, but a handful of meal in a barrel, and a little oil in a cruse. And behold, I am gathering two sticks that I may go in, dress it for me and my son, and we may eat and die." And Elijah said unto her, this is what he said, "Fear not." First thing he said, "Fear not. Go and do as I said, but make me therefore a little cake first, and bring it unto me out to make for thee and thy son." So first of all, he said, "Don't fear." A lot of times we get in those places in like a drought, fear want to come. You know, the first thing we try to do, okay, you try to figure it out. Okay, I see this is going on. Nothing is happening. Okay, in your mind, you're trying to figure out, maybe if I do this, it's going to help. Maybe if I do this, we're trying to figure out ourselves. We're not relying on God. And we're walking in fear begin to come. And sometimes that happens to all of us. I'm sure we all have stories that we're in a tight place and it seems like nothing is happening. It's very unproductive. And we in our mind get to going like, "I need to do something, make something happen." We don't want to wait on God. We don't want to wait on the promise. We don't wait on what he has. We're kind of like want to jump like, "Oh, I got to do something." But in those moments are very crucial that we are sensitive to the Spirit of God and that we, slow down, get into the Word. What does the Word say about it? Watch who is around us. Because a lot of times when you're being obedient to God, really want to do what God called you to do in those situations, you're going to have people that don't understand. "I wouldn't do that if I was you. Why are you doing that?" They don't understand. But we have to stay focused and have faith in God and what God has told you. I don't care how long it was ago, whatever God has showed you or told you or the word of the Lord has been spoken, you have to really trust in God, but you have to stay focused on the word. You can't hear a lot of things going in your ear that get you off track. Because what happens, you would do something you shouldn't do, and you can mess up what God has for you. So let me read the other verses. And it says, Elijah said unto her, "Fear not." And he said, "Go do what I told you to do." Verse 15, and she went and did according to the saying of Elijah. She and he in her house did meet many days, so provision was there. And the barrel of meal wasted not, because she was like, "Hey, this all I got. I ain't got but a little bit." Did not, and the crew, and did neither did the cruse of oil fail, according to the word of the Lord, which he spake through by Elijah. So the word of the Lord came, he spoke the word. So she had to have, you know, she had to like let go of that fear that she had, like, "This is all I got. We ain't got nothing. There's a drought, we're gonna die." You know what I'm saying? So you may be in a situation where you feel like, "This is all I have. I don't see no way this is going to happen. The time, you know, the clock is ticking, you know, and I don't see how this is going to work out." But we have to stay focused on the word of God, even the word that was spoken over your life. I'm not saying it's easy. I'm not saying it's just going to be automatic, but we have to be intentional about staying focused on the word of God. So be intentional about this. Surround yourself with people who are going to speak those things into you that's going to help to feed, you know, to help water what God has already told you, you know, so it can come, you know, to help encourage you along the way. So you may be in a drought. You may be in a season to where it's like nothing is happening. I don't see nothing. I ain't, you know, things are getting slim. But that's just the point. We have to really trust God. We go to church, we send all these songs. God is awesome. He's worthy to praise. He's a mighty God. But okay, that don't mean nothing when you're in that situation. Let him be that mighty God. Let him be awesome in your situation. So this is just coming to encourage you in that moment where you may be experiencing drought and you need some provision. God will provide. It may be something small, but I believe that God will provide for you in that moment. Don't jump the gun. Don't go do something real quick. Stay calm. Stay focused. You know, because sometimes you want to just do it. You know, I got to find somewhere to get out. I got to find something to do. But God wants you to trust him. He wants you to not lean on your understanding, but lean on him.